100 athletes have made their way back home from Pyeongchang in the 2018 Winter Games. Many looking a little weary and worse for wear and tear, both in the games and the more than 10-hour flight, landing at San Francisco International Airport. In Duluth, a cheerful welcome home last night for the U.S. men's curling team, which, of course, won its first gold medal.
That's right. Today, the celebrating continues with a party at the city's convention center. Ellery McArdle joins us with a look at the emotional return back to Minnesota. Good morning, Ellery.
Good morning. I love this video we're going to show you guys. Yeah. It's like cue the waterworks, because this is four of the five guys returning home to Duluth last night to a crowd of about 300 people. Tyler George just instantly starts crying when he sees that crowd. Then you've got, because the tour didn't end there, John Schuster, the skip, waving from the Duluth Curling Club, also showing off his gold medal, and then, of course, had to grab a bite at Sammy's Pizza. So let's give you a closer look at that welcome home from another angle. There's Tyler's face in awe when he sees the crowd there. Now, after the team hugged their families, people took selfies with the team and asked for autographs. The U.S. team has overcome so much. John Schuster was basically an afterthought after finishing last in the 2010 Olympics and next to last in 2014. But the so-called rejects, they got redemption, and now they're back home with gold medals. People in Duluth say you cannot give up on these guys.
You always dream of moments like this for you, where you're representing your country and come home to so much pride and excitement.
Seeing all the kids and all the enthusiasm, that's what we do this for.
We cannot forget about their fifth member of the team, Matt Hamilton, and his famous mustache. He arrived home to Madison yesterday to clapping and hugs, and he showed off his gold medal there as well. As we mentioned, more athletes arriving home from Pyeongchang as well. Here's more tweets. Minnesota's own Jessie Diggins in the cockpit of her Delta flight showing off her gold medal. We've got Lindsey Vonn tweeting tons of hearts, saying finally home. And our very own Bee Chang, her and Dave Schwartz are heading back today from Pyeongchang. She's thanking the volunteers. And then Dave's got a great Team Tegna squad pose there. We are very excited for those guys to come home today too.
Most definitely.
Their families too. Yep.
Yeah.
Thank you, Ellery. Yep. Yeah, and this has been trending. The Simpsons episode from 8 years ago that shows the U.S. beating out Sweden for Olympic gold. People have been tweeting, sharing, talking about it. Simpsons been on air for nearly 30 seasons and has had other predictions, like Donald Trump becoming president. They're good.
A lot of crazy predictions in The Simpsons. Wow. Yeah, not so crazy. All right, national news this morning. The United States Supreme Court has weighed in on the DACA drama. Dreamers are the group of undocumented people here in the U.S. who were brought to this country illegally by their parents when they were children. The High Court refused to rule on the Trump administration plan, which seeks to end special protections for that group. This decision is big, as it could keep a legal shield in place for nearly 700,000 young immigrants for the rest of the year. Meanwhile, President Trump is preparing for his first visit to California since taking office. President's going there to look at prototypes for the potential border wall with Mexico. We'll hear more about the planned visit later this morning on the Today Show.
President Trump is also hitting hard against the Broward County Sheriff deputies who responded to the scene of the Florida school shooting 2 weeks ago. The president claiming deputies, quote, choked, were a disgrace, specifically talking about armed campus officer Scott Peterson, who never entered the building while an active shooter killed 17 people. Peterson's attorney says the allegations that Mr. Peterson was a coward are untrue, and that Peterson, who resigned last week, took up a tactical position because he thought the shots were coming from outside of the building. Today, the Broward County Commission will meet for the first time since the school shooting. Commissioners will issue a proclamation to honor the Coconut Creek police officer who arrested the shooting suspect. They will also consider demolishing the building at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas where the shooting took place. And as those Florida students head back to the classroom, we're hearing from one of the survivors of the shooting who had an amazing recovery.
And I'd just like to say that I'm so grateful to be here, and it wouldn't be possible without those officers and first responders and these amazing doctors. And
student Maddie Wilford was hit by 3 bullets in her stomach, chest, and her hand. First responders found her, first thinking she was dead. Now, 3 surgeries later, she's home and walking.
Police are investigating an early morning shooting in Minneapolis that left 2 men wounded. Police say the victims were walking in the 400 block of Hennepin Avenue South just after midnight when a vehicle passed and someone shot at them. The two suffered non-life-threatening injuries. Police say the vehicle involved is described as a blue or black compact or small car. No arrests have been made. Anyone with information is urged to contact Crime Stoppers. A man will spend the rest of his life in prison for shooting and killing a Minneapolis grandmother. 22-year-old Joshua Izika was found guilty on 5 charges, including first-degree murder. In May 2016, prosecutors say Izika was shooting at members of a rival gang when he shot and killed Burdell Beeks, who was at a stop sign in her van at the time. The Beeks family still struggling with the fact that Izika never came forward to confess his crime.
It's hard for me to still believe that he was able to come outside of his door every day and see a picture of my mom and still not come forward. So there's obviously no remorse.
The Beeks family went on to make a plea yesterday for the violence to stop.
An update now to a story we've been following. Police have released the name of a teenager struck and killed by a North Star commuter rail train Sunday night. Police say 17-year-old Grayson Dow of Elk River was killed while walking on the tracks near Ogden Street Northwest and 192nd Avenue in Elk River. They say another person walking with Dow saw the train approaching and was able to get out of the way. There was no crossing or intersection at that point on the tracks. Well, how much money would the state of Minnesota make converting existing freeways to toll roads? It's a question MnDOT study was commissioned to answer. The legislature asked for the study last year, and MnDOT returned yesterday with some preliminary figures. Turning I-94 into a toll road would bring in the most money, roughly $5 billion over the next 30 years. But about half of that would go to upkeep and collecting the tolls. And of course, on our social media pages, a lot of people not pleased about even the word tollways here in Minnesota.
You have to think about what, you know, setting those up, what does that do to the flow of traffic?
Exactly. We already deal with congestion issues within the Twin Cities Metro itself, so that's why they're doing this study, though.
Yeah.
The importance of it.
I don't know. We'll see. I think let's start with expanding from one lane to get to 94 off of 394. You know?
Yeah. Right now, the traffic pretty quiet for the Tuesday morning commute. If you're waking up in Hugo, 35E southbound and northbound, pretty quiet there, main streets. Road conditions also looking good around the Twin Cities. No crashes or delays, as we've been mentioning, though. Watch for a little bit of refreeze, especially on those side streets, city streets, and, of course, your sidewalk as you head out the door.
That's right. Temperatures are back below freezing, well below freezing in some places. St. Cloud at 8. It's 18 in Lake Elmo, but hanging on to 27 at the airport. Most of the metro in the 20s. We're headed into the low 40s this afternoon after we burn off a little fog and some low clouds. Another day of melting.
Here we go. Thank you, Sven.
All right. Still to come on Sunrise, a major change could be coming to the Vikings lineup. Case Keenum led the Vikes to the NFC Championship, but now it's looking more likely that Case may be moving on.
Plus, it's not the scene of a sci-fi movie. It's Minneapolis, and it's being flocked by crows while they're picking the area as their place to nest this season.